Jay James with Rise Carry Fitness and American Parkour, and this is going to be a philosophy video. One of my students asked me to start making video logs when I first left North Carolina and moved here to Los Angeles, so here's the first one. This first video is on a quote, which is that you miss 100% of the shots that you don't take. This is one of my favorite quotes because it can apply to so many different things. I always picture like a basketball hoop when I say it. Think of it that way, like you're on a basketball court, you've got the ball in your hands. Maybe you can see that ball as willpower. That's the power that you hold in physical form. And you wanna put that, or rather, you want to use your strength to put that object in the basketball hoop. So that's where your will comes into play. And you know, if you're too afraid to take that shot, you're standing there, whether there are people around or whether you're by yourself, it's still like a very on-the-spot moment where you're faced with a choice or a decision. And you're never gonna get that ball in the hoop unless you can overcome your fear to try. A lot of people have a fear of failure, and so instead of even trying something, they will not even attempt it because they rather not feel the discomfort of failure, you know, failure and rejection. So my whole thing is, until you take the ball and, you know, visualize it going in and give it your best and take that shot, there's absolutely no way that you're going to make it, you know? And that can be applied to many things, you know, dreams, goals, things that you want to do, people that you want to meet. There's another quote, not to really trail off topic, but this is kind of how it goes. Like, I think it was Will Smith who said it. I don't remember exactly who said it, but there's never gonna be the perfect time and the perfect moment. You have to create the perfect time, the perfect place, the perfect situation. You have to create the perfect moment. So you can't sit around waiting for that perfect time to go do something. You have to create that yourself. And that's, you hold that power in your will, but you cannot be afraid to make decisions. That's why me personally, I make it a big deal in my own mind to make decisions, you know, to be decisive. Like if someone asks me a question, I hate saying I don't know, because I personally find it really annoying when like someone can't make a decision, like just because it's like it doesn't get you anywhere. Saying I don't know it's an answer that means nothing. It's an answer with no value, you know. So when I'm asked a question, I always try to give a yes or no answer. I try to be straight and precise with it, and that comes down to decision making. But a lot of this really revolves around fear. So yeah, just keep in mind whether it's your goals with training, whether it's a new move you want to get, or something that you feel like you need. Like, there are certain moves that I feel like I need them. Like, they're a part of who I am, waiting to be captured and then brought back out through myself. Whether it's moves or tests or jobs, auditions, like, you can't be afraid to try, you know? Because if you are, you're never gonna get anywhere. That's like a sure outcome. If you don't take that shot, just keep it in mind. So just keep that in mind. 100% of the shots that you don't take. You miss 100% of the shots that you don't take. There have been times where I've been nervous about doing something, or like I knew I wanted something, and it was just, it came down to, okay, like, this is the moment, like, right now. And that moment's always fleeting when you have that thought. It's like, here's an opportunity, and this opportunity, the window of this opportunity is slowly closing like this. This happens all the time. And it's like, you have that amount of time before that window's gone, that window's closed. And you had to make the decision in your mind right there. All right, am I going to take this shot, or am I just not even going to try? And the answer is automatically no. You never know until you give it that shot. So I encourage you to just take the shot, you know? Failure is a part of the process. Failure is a step forward, okay? Keep that in mind. Failure is a step forward. Think of it, for all the different chessers and chessuses out there, think of it like learning a new movement, or learning like a flip specifically for the people that are watching that aren't parkour practitioners. I'll break it down a little bit more. Learning a flip is basically having the will to try and fail repeatedly in a safe environment until you finally land on your feet. That's simply what it is. When you throw your first flip ever, you have a certain idea in mind, and you can visualize what the outcome should look like. And it's simply just having a safe environment for you to fall repeatedly over and over and over and over and over again without breaking your bones and hurting yourself, until finally your body has the muscle memory that it needs to whip you over to feel that image that you're trying to create through your actions. Until finally you have the muscle memory that when you throw it and you visualize it, your body knows that it needs to go over. It spins quick because you've been doing it over and over and over again. Until finally, there's that one little adjustment. Maybe you put your chin down and then boom, boom, there you are on your feet. And then everything feels amazing. That's kind of how life works. You just got to try things. You have to be willing to fail. You cannot be afraid of failure. So when I see something that I want, that's a key thing too, is knowing what you want. Keep in mind, what is it that I want? What is it that I'm working for? What is it that I'm working towards? This all comes down to direction, and I'll make a different video about that soon. But you first have to know what you want, and then you need to keep in mind that quote. You miss 100% of the shots that you don't take. And that really applies directly to the moment when it comes, when you're sitting there and you're in the moment and you realize, now is my chance to make this happen. I have to be the best that I can be and try this. This is where you get that decision. Do you choose to be too afraid and just not do it? Or do you say, no, I'm gonna go try it, you know? Because if you don't try, the answer is automatically no. If you do try, it opens up these two options where it's yes and no. You'd much rather have that option of yes and no, because then it's 50-50. It can go one of two ways. Either you're going to shoot that ball and it's going to go in the hoop, or you're going to shoot the ball and it's going to bounce off and miss. But the key thing is, there are opportunities that come around only once. And if you don't take them, you're not going to get another chance. And those hurt. You don't want to sit around regretting something that you were too afraid to even try on. The other awesome thing is, you can always try and get exactly what you want. Get that yes that you've been wanting. And that's an amazing feeling. It's better to try and fail than have never tried at all. That's something worth being proud of. This is Jay James with Rise Carry Fitness and American Parkour. And that was your Rise Philosophy Food for Thought. Have a good day.